Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's video I'm going to share with you two recipes of how you can reinvent a meal so that you save time and money as well. Here I had about 4 kilograms of potatoes in my cupboard. Quite a lot of them were kind of going off, so I decided that I needed to use them up. I had this big pot which I fill up with about 2 kilograms of potatoes. They were peeled and I put them in cold water. I brought them to the boil with some salted water. As well, I'm using my instant pot, and in here I put again about 2 kilograms of potatoes. In here it doesn't really matter how many potatoes you put as long as they fit inside the pot. And I added 2 instant pot measuring cups of water and I set it on pressure cook for 5 minutes. Then go ahead and mash them up, and if you are going to store them for later use, which in this case, because I made so many potatoes, I just had to freeze them up so that they didn't go before I was able to use them. I'm going to put all of this in a Ziploc bag. Try not to add anything other than the salt that already has for the seasoning that you added into the water. Let them cool down, and once they are cool, pop them in the freezer. Now for the mashed potatoes for today's meal, I'm going to use English mustard, Dijon mustard, milk, butter, as well as mature cheddar cheese. The first thing that I normally do is add the butter, and then I let it sit there until it melts. I whisk it all up, and then once that's sorted, then I add 1 teaspoon of English mustard, and then 1 of Dijon mustard, as well as some more salt and pepper if it's needed, some grated cheese. It just seems to have a richer taste if you add the cheddar cheese. As well, I'm adding a splash of milk, and I go little by little just to ensure that I don't end up with too runny consistency for the mashed potatoes. Now for the rest of the meal, I normally use chipolata sausages, which are the ones that my family really like, and I would use vegetarian sausages for me. I normally tend to have only 2 just because I find them very filling and they just do the job. And here I am pairing this meal with some sweet corn and peas, as well as put some gravy on top, and this is all meal for day one. Now for the meal two, I'm going to reuse exactly the same things that I used for meal one. These are the leftover sausages, as well as the leftover mashed potato from yesterday that is already seasoned, some bell peppers, quite a few onions because I already have this in my fridge. You could use some mushrooms if you have. I didn't have any, so this is what I'm gonna be using for the sausage casserole that I'm gonna be making. As well, I'm gonna add some more sausages just to make it a little bit more dense. I might be able to actually squeeze 2 meals out of this second meal. Now I am also going to fry the vegetarian sausages, but because I don't want to be digging out for the vegetarian sausages once the sausage casserole is cooked, I am going to put them in a separate casserole dish. Now for the sauce that the sausages are going to have, here I have some gravy. You can use vegetarian gravy, use any type of gravy that you like. Just make it up to the package instructions with boiling water. And once you have the amount of liquid that you need, then just divide it into the 2 casserole dishes that you have. I made roughly about 1 liter of gravy. Now I should have loosened up the mashed potatoes from the day before in a saucepan with some more milk, but instead of that I decided to use the microwave, and as you can see, dried them up. So it still worked out, but if you want it to be a little bit more easy to spread, then I suggest that you loosen them up until it reaches the consistency that you want to use for the dish. Now I'm going to show you something that I do to try to fit both of these casserole dishes in my small section of the oven, because I don't want to preheat the bigger section if I can actually get away with cooking them in the smaller section. So here I have the insert of that, which is normally for the grill, but as you can see it's got raised edges, which stops both of the pans to sit nicely on it. So what I'm going to do is put a metal sheet, which I normally use for my pizzas, upside down, so that way it creates a flatter, longer surface where I can actually put both of those casserole dishes fitting nicely in the small section of the oven, which saves electricity because that section actually heats up quicker. I am going to serve this dish with some broccoli. So this is frozen broccoli, which I just need to put a tiny bit of water and then just put it on the high setting for about 10 to 15 minutes until it's cooked through. Now the casserole is ready. And trust me, it tasted delicious. It didn't retain its shape as in it normally does it with a cottage pie, you know, where the mashed potato on the top remains on the top. With this dish, everything kind of got mixed up, but it still tasted delicious. I probably could have done with cutting the vegetables a little bit smaller and maybe even adding less gravy than I did. But to be honest, no one complained for the extra gravy they had. If anything, it actually made the dish taste nicer. From this dish, it was definitely enough for 2 days, because as you can see, though, I still have half a leftover portion for each of the dishes that I had. So this was great overall. Yes, you were gonna end up having the same meal twice, but if you are running out of time, if you are pressuring time, exams, housework, kids, school runs and things like that, or just sometimes you just don't fancy cooking and want to save a little bit of money, this is great, because you know you're gonna have a healthy meal without having to invest so much of your time or money into it. I hope that you enjoyed this video and I'll see you in my next one. Until then, stay strong, healthy and happy.